Hi, it's Ursula from ursula-smith.com, and today I'm just doing a quick tip video. It's not really a tutorial because there's plenty of tutorials out there on saltwater etching, but I just wanted to show you what I use to make these etched copper pieces. So here's the first thing. I started out using batteries the way that a lot of the tutorials describe, but quickly decided that was not the way to go since I'm etching big things and the batteries run out pretty quickly. So I switched and started using this battery charger that I got at Aubuchon Hardware. You can get them, I'm sure, at Ace and Home Depot and the like. 12 volts. I set it at 10 amps and standard. And then it's got the positive and the negative clamps already attached. You attach the negative to a piece of copper. This is just bezel wire, thicker bezel wire that I've wrapped over and over and over again to just get one big old hunk of copper. And then basically, I used distilled water, so it didn't have any minerals or anything in it. Really clean water. Kosher salt, so it doesn't have any iodine in it. A lot of the recipes say to heat the water, add the salt. I did not do that. I just dumped about probably a cup and a half of salt into this Tupperware thing. I'm going to actually move this to a covered container. I had to go out and buy one. So this one's deep enough, and so is my new one, that I can put in a big piece of copper, you know, something like that. And so what I do is, I mix the water together. I add citric acid because that binds with the copper and it's easier to dispose of. You don't want to put copper down into your water system. So you attach the black clamp to your big old hunk of copper piece. And then what I have found, the best thing, I was taping these pieces and the tape would fall off and it was just kind of a pain. So what I started doing with these pieces, depending on, and I'm gonna have another video that I'm gonna show you guys how to use vinyl to do the mask, but even with paint and stays on and nail polish and all the like, what I do is I basically make a hook from another piece of copper and then I hang it on the other side and I kind of bend it around so that it, you know, holds on to the piece of copper, and then you attach the red clamp to that piece of wire that goes in the bath. And then once that's all set up, then I will turn on the battery charger and the etching process will begin. For these bigger pieces of copper, I find it takes about an hour. A lot of the tutorials will say 15 minutes. I find to get a nice etch, and again, for these bigger pieces, it takes at least an hour, and it comes out really nice, and it's super simple. I wouldn't even start out with the batteries, quite frankly, because I went through four of them and didn't even get that deep an etch and had to come back in with the battery charger to finish it off. So I go straight for the battery charger. You don't have to buy the ferric chloride or any of that kind of stuff, so it seems like the way to go. There's some videos, or some tutorials that talk about using, I think it's copper sulfate instead of just the kosher salt. I haven't tried that yet, so I can't tell you whether that makes it faster or easier. The salt water was all I used with the addition of the citric acid, and I bought the citric acid online at Amazon. Super simple. And seems to work pretty well. So anyway, give it a shot. Thanks for joining me. See you next time. One last thing. These are just copper tubes that I've also etched. I used white stays on instead of the black for these tubes. These I just bought at the hardware store. And I did the same thing. I just took a piece of copper and made like a little hook and hanger and then hung it over the side of the bath. And those etched great too. So anyway, give saltwater etching a try and hopefully you're as successful as I was. Having a ball doing it. Good luck. Thanks for joining me. See you next time.